New Orleans voodoo is often oversimplified. There's probably more bad information out there about what voodoo is than there is good information.
It started with the Inquisition. They kill babies, they sacrifice them and then eat them. They have depraved wild orgies in the forest and they serve Satan and they're against God. And none of this is true. It's not about spellcraft and hexing people, and you don't stick pins into dolls. You don't try to make somebody's nose fall off or make somebody fall in love with you. It's a religion. Everybody knows the word voodoo and knows absolutely nothing about it.
The real people are never honestly public simply because of what Hollywood made out of voodoo, that to expose themselves is to expose themselves to ridicule. You don't pick voodoo. Voodoo picks you.
There is no way to practice voodoo or to experience voodoo without knowing something about the history of it. Slaves were taken from Africa, the Bambara people, and brought into the Americas. And then following the Haitian Revolution, 10,000 refugees came out of Haiti and entered into the port of New Orleans.
This is a city that has a significant African presence. You've got these multi-layers of different, both waves of Africans and waves of colonizers, and you get an extra special kind of multinational interesting here.
People come to me because universally we're all looking for the meaning of our immortal souls. Why are we alive? Why are we here? So a great deal of what I do is try to heal communities. The rituals of voodoo are surprisingly sophisticated, exquisitely beautiful, quite elegant, and incredibly creative.
Jazz is voodoo. The object of a New Orleans voodoo ceremony is to become possessed. You induce possession by dancing.
When you go through possession experience, it's an expansion that's almost indescribable, that you go beyond the borders of your own identity. You can get outside of yourself and experience the world from a completely different perspective. All of the different voodoo spirits have different likes and dislikes. It's as if you were inviting your grandmother to dinner and you want to offer food and drink that she likes and it's going to let her know that she's being welcomed and honored.
Some people are aware that there's possible giving offering, and some people do bring cigarettes, tobacco. But if I am needing to do a cleansing or prepare for a ritual, you can use alcohol or perfume, incense, etc. If you have nothing but you, you are the offering for the spirit. We all are the offering to the spirit.
Voodoo is a direct connection with the spirits. You don't have the intermediary of scripture. You don't separate sacred from secular in voodoo. You don't separate religion from recreation. Voodoo doesn't have a certain day or a certain place, so it's universal.
There are African and African-American people that have this religious practice that may have a sort of supernatural powers that may help them if they feel that their neighbor is stealing their chickens or trying to steal their wife or up to no good.
You want to get a promotion and you're competing against someone else and you want him to have a car wreck. You have to go find a corrupt voodoo priest. What they do is they in turn know how to corrupt the spirits by bribing them. When the spirit is bribed, the spirit's whole personality changes. It's not the voodoo that's dark. It comes from the individual who in turn corrupts the spirit.
New Orleans' modern voodoo landscape is so complicated.
People look to New Orleans as being that mystical pole of mysterious forces coming up.
Voodoo in itself is neither good nor bad. It's a power. Voodoo actually took people out of slavery into freedom, out of the ordinary into the extraordinary, and out of being human beings to being spiritual beings.